Hi everyone. So in this video, we are going to talk about Dockerfile. I mean, in the previous set of videos, we talked about volume mapping, port mapping, Docker networking, but we haven't talked about how to write Dockerfile and how to create image out of it, which you can run and create a container. Okay, so we'll just write a simple basic Dockerfile. Okay, and we will just understand these different set of commands, different set of instructions which we are writing in the Docker file. So I will create an empty file and I will put them and we'll try to talk about these one by one. We'll just zoom it. So Docker file is nothing but this is a kind of file which we are going to write, right? And we are using these different Docker tags, work directory from copy, run, expose, cmd, label, right? All these kind of instructions we are writing in the Docker file. So indirectly, what you can say is Docker file is just a set of instruction so that you can create image based on whatever the instruction you have added. Okay, I want to take a base image of Ubuntu, then I want to install Red Hat, I want to install Nginx on top of it, and I will create my own custom image. I'm using Node Carbon as a base image. Okay, I will actually copy my code from the local to the container. I will expose some port and I will run npm run start, npm run debug, npm run deploy command in the Docker container. So whenever the Docker container comes up, you will have Node.js, Java, Python, or any environment up and running with the application deployed on the container. Okay, that's why you see these kind of commands, npm run start, nginx minus z. In the Node.js container, you will see npm start. Right, so you have written some set of instruction. What you are saying is, in for creating this container, I am writing this Docker image, which is taking base carbon image. Working directory of that container is source. I'm copying whatever I have locally to that container, and I'm getting inside the container and I'm doing npm install before I do npm run start, right? And I'm exposing 3000 port. So after looking at the instruction, it is going to create an image, and when you run the image, you will see a Node.js process running there, because in the Docker file, what you have done is you copied your local Node.js code into the container. You did npm install, all the libraries are available. You are exposing 3000 port because your Node.js HTTP server is going to run on 3000 port. Okay. So we'll understand these different terminologies, what you have. So almost every Docker file you will come across will have a from tag. Okay, this instruction will set the base image. Like we are writing from node carbon. So this is actually, it will look into the Docker registry and will try to see what is the node carbon image, or node latest, or simply node alpine. Lot of variants are available for Node.js container. Okay, so this is from. You can optionally specify the tag also, like latest or a particular version you wanted to add, like from Ubuntu or from Ubuntu latest, right? Why am I writing in caps? Ubuntu, you can specify something like this, right? Run command. So next thing is we can talk about run command. So this instruction does what it sees. Okay. So if you just look at the Docker file, if you see the run command, what it is doing is, these are like shell command which you run. Cd means go to source directory and do the npm install, right? So from the command itself, it is clear what need to be done. Copy command is specifically saying I'm being used to copy the files or whatever the content I have. Dot means from the current working directory in the root folder, I will copy everything into the src of the container. Okay, so docker run copy. These are some set of commands. So run copy is clear. Then we have a cmd. So what cmd command is, instruction sets a default command, right? In our Docker file. So this is a default command. Once the container is coming up, it will run the npm start. Okay. So you can write any kind of shell command. Here is echo hi, echo hello, or you have some command which you need to run to start the Node.js container, then you will put it here inside an array. Copy command instruction copies the folder from your local system to the Docker image. to your Docker image, right? So once the container is up, you will see your local content is available inside a Docker container, right? Then other thing is add. Copy and add actually used for similar purpose. We are not using it. So what it does is they both let you copy files from specific location into Docker image. The add instruction let you to do the same as the copy instruction, but on top it supports two other sources. Like you can extract a tar file from your source directory directly. You can use URL instead of a local file system. Okay, so you can see something like add dot hello dot tar. You can just directly put that in the root folder of your container, right? So it will extract a tar into your root. Okay, you can also use a URL. Here you can just specify the HTTP URL, some blah blah dot com, and you are getting tar and you are copying it to the root. Okay, so working directory is we are using in our containers. Working directory is actually we are setting in the container that, okay, for container I'm setting this as a working directory, and here I will do all the things. So you will see this instruction as a second line in most of the Docker file. What it is saying is, okay, you will copy the content here, you will do the npm install here, everything will be done on this working directory of the project. So workdir instruction is used to define the working directory of container at any given time, right? The command is specified in the Docker file. So after this, we are writing run, cmd, add, copy, or entry point instructions will be executed in that specified directory only. So once you set this, all the other commands will be executed in that specified current working directory only. So I think these are the basics. Now we have other commands also, which is talking about the same entry point. Entry point, another important point is entry point in the Docker file. The entry point instruction of a Docker file looks similar to the CMD, right? So entry point, we can actually use it for the running, executing some command, right? In the Docker file also, we are using CMD. Similarly, we can use this entry point ls, right? It specifies the default command to execute at the runtime, and you will not be able to override it. So if you are specifying entry point, what the entry point instruction is doing, it is somewhat similar to the CMD. Like CMD we are using to spin up the container once the container comes up. Similarly, this entry point we are specifying, so this is the default command which we are executing once the container runtime environment comes up, right? Entry point ls. So whenever you build the image and you actually start the container, then this is the first command that you will get. You will see. Okay, so Docker file and the CMD and entry point both are different how they works. And we have a env command. Env instruction allow you to set the environment variable for your Docker containers, right? You can set something like this in your Docker container. You can put it anywhere. Working directory equal to, okay, anything is GitHub token or something, and you can just specify the value. Okay, so this is environment variable that will be available for your Docker runtime environment. Then we have just a basic label and health check and all. So you can just look at the documentation. Label is actually used to just define, I think, who is going to be the maintainer. Label instruction allows you to add the metadata to the image, like email you wanted to add, key value pair, right? And maintainer you wanted to add. And if you have a lot of different Docker images, right, you can filter based on these labels, because if every Docker image is having labels, it is easy to filter out based on a particular label. Okay, these are like some particular commands I can see. Now you can write a Docker file for your applications. This is a multiple container setup in a single Docker file. What we are doing is we are putting this as a build dependency, right? And then we are doing setting a working directory, copying the package lock and yarn lock to the working directory. Once you set the working directory, you don't need to specify it every time. Okay, I mean, in this Docker file, we are specifying it. That's not needed. You can just set dot dot. You can just do the npm install. It will run these commands into the working directory which you have set only. Okay, and here we are just copying the folders, copying the files to the container, then we are doing yarn build, and then we are actually pulling the Nginx image and putting the build. So here we are putting, doing a dependency, right? Copy the artifacts from the build dependency container. This is actually the folder, and we are copying this to here. Okay, that's why we have created alias for this container. So this is like we have a Node.js container and having Nginx running together in the same container. Okay, so because from the build we are getting some static HTML files, and this Nginx container is actually able to expose that inject in the index.html, which we are getting in the build folder. Okay, other examples are same, like this is the same example we had for the Nginx. We are taking the event2 as a base image. I have added a label. Label can be a key value pair, maintainer, or anything. We can filter out based on that. I installed Nginx on top of it. I'm exposing a port so that this container at the runtime will be exposing port 80, and then we can just do the mapping. Okay, 8080 port of host will map to the 80 of the container. Other examples are kind of similar. Okay. So that's it about the Docker files.